I'm Lee Bannister and welcome to our weekly look into the Postbag. Now, Chanel's taking a break this week, and so during the next half hour or so, I'll be taking a look back over the past week here on Big Centre TV. And then we'll look ahead to see what's coming up during next week as well. Oh, and we'll be finding out what some of you have been saying to us too. So remember, if you'd like to get in touch about anything at all, then there are so many ways in which you can do so. On social media, that's Facebook and Twitter, just look us up, do a search for Big Centre TV. Or if you want to use the good old email, then it's postbag@bigcentre.tv. And if you fancy actually sending us a real letter in the post, then our address is Postbag, Big Centre TV, 14A Lower Hall Lane, Walsall, WS1 1RL. And I'll be reading out a selection of the messages we've received during the coming half hour. Now, over the last few weeks, we've been holding various competitions. The first was to win merchandise from the rock band E of E. All our viewers had to do was email in, letting us know the name of the lead singer of the band. Well, just in case you missed it, here's Chanel Shea Calvin with the lead singer and guitarist drawing out the lucky winners.
So, do you want to draw the first one?
Yep. Okay. Shall I reveal it?
Yep.
So, the winner is Sue Green.
Oh, well done, Sue. The next one. Quite a few to get through.
Next winner is Abby Simpson Bagnall.
Oh,
yeah. Another one.
Don't take that.
Don't know where to put these now.
Okay, next one is Tammy Dunford.
Well done, Tammy.
Next one is Giovanna Sanid. I hope I said that right. I'm sorry.
Either way, you've won some points anyway, so that make up for it.
Next one is Charlotte Lewis.
Oh, well done, Charlotte.
Congratulations.
And last but not least.
Just mix it around.
Mix it around a bit.
Got Michelle Leyland.
Oh, and in case you were wondering, the lead singer's name is Tom Harris. Did you get that right? Well, as you saw, the winner of the grand prize was Charlotte Lewis, and she bagged herself a pair of tickets to see the band at Lichfield Rocks. So congratulations, Charlotte. Now, the second competition that we've been holding was for you to win some spy merchandise from the movie The Spy. Carl Jones asked viewers who they thought would make the best spy, and the best answers would get themselves that special prize. Well, Brian Cockerill said Richard Burton in Where Eagles Dare, 1968. A great film. Richard Burton makes his German officer character the most believable. A great spy. Brett Hill emailed in, nominating his wife, as she always knows what he's up to before he can tell her. And Chris Thacker said, the Phantom Flamflinger from Tiswas will make an excellent spy. Concealed in the shadows by his dark clothing, he can enter unawares and could hide many a suspicious item in his robes. And let's be honest, it took him 30 years to identify him. By that time, he'd have long departed any scene. And you're talking about my old mate Benny Mills there. Great comments. Thanks to everyone who entered our competitions. Now, are you looking for a drama group for children? Well, check out ACTS, A-C-T-S, which is based in Wolverhampton. And it's run by one of the guests that appeared on What's On.
Fun! Exciting!
Acting! Creativity!
Remember where you're coming from. Remember who you are. Wolverhampton's made of melodies. Remember you're a star. Remember where you're coming from. Remember who you are. Wolverhampton's made of melodies. Remember you're a star.
Remember where you're coming from. Remember who you are. Wolverhampton's made of melodies. Remember you're a star.
Game. Crazy.
Remember who you are. Wolverhampton's made of melodies. Remember you're a star.
I'm a star. You're a star. We're all stars. Bright, shiny stars. You're a star. We're all stars. Bright, shiny stars.
Acting, creating, playing in school.
Tanya,
act.
Amazing.
Fun.
I'm a star. You're a star.
What do you suppose her thing said to my nose?
She lifts me up. Quite easily,
I can't live.
Exciting!
Friends! Is your child interested in joining a class full of drama, crazy games, exciting opportunities, and fun? Well, look no further. sign up for Tony Daly Campbell's Axe. Call us on 0779 555 6853.
Great stuff there. Now, if you have a company or a business of your own that you'd like to advertise on the channel, but are put off by the price, then you're in luck, because we're holding a competition where you can get yourself some free advertising right here on Big Centre TV. And I'll have the details for you in a few minutes' time. But first, it's time for us to take a look at some of the programmes from the past week here on Big Centre TV. And first up, it's In Our House. It's our news programme for younger viewers, which is on at Wednesdays at 7 o'clock. Let's have a look at one of the stories they covered this week.
This summer there will be owls all over the city. Different groups of people are painting them and putting them on display. Some will be sold for charity. At St George's School we have also made our owls, owl bracelets, owl cupcakes and owl balloons. The money will be going to the Children's Hospital.
And following that, at Wednesdays at 7:30, it's Carib Asia. It's our cookery show. The name kind of speaks for itself. It's presented by a married couple, Cherie and Patrick Hart, and they've already dished up a finger-licking jerk chicken and chicken biryani dish. So let's take a look at what was on the menu this week.
We're going to make fish curry, fish chowder, and fish cakes as well, with Irish potato and sweet potato also. I'm looking forward to this.
Do you know what? We're going to stuff a fish as well.
Okay.
Do you want to take a look at what we've got?
Go through very quickly what the fish is then that we've got.
All right, so first of all, we've got the prawns. Mm-hmm. They're grey, yep. Only because they're not cooked, yep. All right? Then we've got a tail of coley.
Yep.
Moving on to snapper. Mm-hmm. And we've got yellowtail snapper and redtail snapper.
Yep.
We all know about mackerel. And then we move over here, we've got crab. So we're gonna have crab curry, crab and coconut curry.
Yeah.
And here we have our wonderful coley tail.
Tell you what, my stomach's rumbling just at the thought of that. Do you want to see how it all turned out? All right, have a look at this.
So as we say on Carib Asian, there you have it. This is our fish day. This is our fish treat. This is where everything is about fish. We started off with the coley.
Fish coley. Feast, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Stuffed with rice.
And what else is in that rice? You've got aubergine, haven't you?
Yeah. Onion and garlic, yeah. And your seasonings. And then we have the fish chowder, which is mackerel and prawns, king prawns. And the vegetables, we've got hard food provisions, yam, sweet potato and pumpkin together with banana. And we have the crab, which is crab and coconut, ideal with rice.
I can see all that crab meat, I want it.
Good, good.
And finally we've got the fish cakes as well, the Carib Asian fish cakes. And we've got red snapper in there with sweet potato, Irish potato as well, and some chili and spices. And literally, we fried them off and homemade breadcrumbs with that as well. Mm. And just basted it with a little bit of egg before we put the breadcrumbs on there. That and that.
Is yours.
Is mine, what I'm looking forward to.
Nice. And that's Carib Asia, Wednesday evenings at 7:30. Other shows that were on last week included our sports chat show, Extra Time, weeknights at 9:30, where this week's guests included former pro footballer Jimmy Walker and also head of commercial at Birmingham City, Ian Dutton. Meanwhile, on Cuppa TV, every day at 10 o'clock in the morning, 4:30 and 8 in the evening, Monica's guests have included Jordan Adams, who performed a smashing version of This Is The Moment, and also Alwyn Jones and Elaine Costigan, who've dedicated their lives to helping others by providing afternoon shows, coffee mornings and meals to the community. Don't worry if you've missed any of these, because they're always available on our online catch-up service alongside Big Centre's other programmes such as the motoring programme, Land Rovers Live, our culture show Wassifer and the property programme Midlands at Home. Just visit bigcentre.tv and go to watch again. And if you want to have a search for the Big Centre TV YouTube channel, you can do, because there's even more on there. Now, just before the break, you remember I mentioned about our new advertising competition. Well, do you fancy the idea of winning a 2-month advertising campaign for your business as in our As Seen on Big Centre TV prize draw? All you've got to do is email your name, company and contact details to us, and the address is asseenontv@bigcentre.tv. Do that before July the 19th and you could be in with a chance of winning this fantastic prize and a chance to see your advert on Freeview Channel 8, Virgin Channel 159 and BigCentre.tv. So that's your name, company and contact details to the email address as seen on TV at BigCentre.tv before the 19th of July. So that's all for part one, but don't go anywhere. We'll be back in a few minutes' time to take a look ahead to next week on Big Centre TV and also to delve into the old postbag. See you after the break. Welcome back to Postbag here on Big Centre TV with me, Lee Bannister. Now for a look at some of our news stories from this week, and a new cultural partnership between the British Library and the Library of Birmingham has been announced. It follows the discussions with the British Library about ways in which the two organisations could work more closely together. The 12-month pilot, supported by the British Library Trust, will test a new model for partnerships between the British Library and libraries across the country. We spoke to Councillor Penny Holbrook, Cabinet Member for Skills, Learning and Culture.
So I'm really pleased to announce today the partnership between the Library of Birmingham and the British Library to deliver a number of pieces of work, but predominantly focusing in the first instance about the Shakespeare's birthday celebration. I think it's really exciting that the British Library want to work with us. The thing we're fantastic at is opening our archive to the public, and that's what they want to come and learn, how we do better. I think we need to be honest that it's not going to solve all of the challenges we face around the Library of Birmingham. This isn't going to allow us to fix that budget problem we've talked about, but it is the start of a new way of working and thinking about who can be our partners and how we can operate that library differently.
And thank you to Birmingham City Council for that interview. Next, one of our reporters, Tom Bowen from the Midland, was lucky enough to catch up with the legendary Ken Dodd in Dudley last Saturday night to talk about saving the Dudley Hippodrome, the wonderful Midland sense of humour and why age doesn't matter unless you're a cheese.
I've been playing Dudley now for many years, actually. It must be 20 years, probably. I played at the Dudley Hippodrome, and then we came here, and it's wonderful. Why? Because of the audience, the people, the sometimes they're called punters. I don't know why, it sounds like there's a gamble in it. But the customers here, the audience, absolutely wonderful. They've got a wonderful sense of humour. People from the Midlands are blessed. They have wonderful chuckle muscles. That's your chuckle muscle that helps you to laugh, you see. And they've got wonderful chuckle. They love jokes about, what was it, men? We laugh at the same things now as they used to laugh at hundreds of years ago. Men, women, girls, boys, money, where you live, your house, the rent, whether the wife still speaks to you.
You mentioned the Dudley Hippodrome there. You've been quite vocal in your support for the Hippodrome, yes. I believe. Last year you actually said you'd perform a free concert there.
I'll help. Just all you need to do is put some good plans into some good plans. And I'll help as much as I can. I'll do a show, yes, anytime, for a theatre, to save theatres, because theatres are beautiful. A theatre is the centre of a town's life. It reflects the town with singing, dancing and humour. Yeah, it's very necessary. All good towns need a theatre.
You turn 88 this year. It's a very high energy career. How do you keep going?
I don't. I flake out. No, I love. I'm stage struck. That's what we used to call anybody who loved going on the stage. He's stage struck. And I've been stage struck since I was about 10 or 12 years old. I'm 21 in here, and this is getting a bit ancient. But age doesn't matter, does it? Unless you're a cheese.
You're expecting a crowd of, I believe, around 800 tonight. How does it make you feel to still be drawing in crowds?
Well, 800 is very nice. 1,000 would be better. Yeah, it shows that people want to laugh more than ever these days. People do want to laugh. Laughter is a beautiful gift, you know. Dogs don't laugh and cats don't laugh. When was the last time you heard your cat say, "Back here, that was a good one"? They don't, you know. Dogs and cats and lions and tigers and elephants, they don't laugh. They might wag their tail, but they don't laugh. We are the only animal, human beings, which is what most of us are. I'll give you the benefit of the doubt. Human beings are the only animal that laughs or cries or needs to. So we should use this gift, this wonderful God-given gift, to good effect. It makes you feel good. A good laugh. Good laugh makes you feel good.
You're on stage in 5 minutes. Can you just quickly tell me a little bit about tonight's show?
Tonight's show, well, it's as I say, we call it the happiness show, but it's a happiness variety show. And variety means, the word variety, think about it, it means a variety of skills. A variety of skills. The people who are with me, on the show with me, the supporting acts, are all people who have given a lifetime to polishing and cutting and adding a little bit and taking a bit away to make their particular turn the best they can possibly get it. So what are you getting? Variety is really the best kind of show business. So it's a variety show. We've got a one of Britain's greatest magician, a wonderful young man. We have another young man who I booked him because he was so much energy, so much. He's like a real live wire. He's like a fireworks display going off. Gary, he plays all kinds of guitars and instruments. We have Sibby Jones, my lady, who is very, very skilled on the piano and plays the flute and sings. Yeah. Oh, and the star of the show is Dickie Mint. Dickie Mint's coming on.
Ken, it's been a pleasure. Best of luck for tonight.
Put it there. Thank you very much. And thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And don't forget, support Variety, support Dudley, and try and get Dudley Hippodrome back.
Ah, good old Doddy. Could listen to him for hours. Come to think of it, I think I have done. Anyway, we've received a few messages about Ken's appearance on Big Centre TV. Caroline Scott said, Ken Dodd, a great entertainer. Storyteller Billy Babu says, by Jove, mister, Jan Bostin. Rob Phillips was very complimentary. Well done, Big Centre, a real coup and just what's needed to boost the ratings. Well, let's hope it goes some way to helping the Dudley Hippodrome, eh? Also, in this week's Postbag, we've had a few comments about Crossroads. I'll have some more for you in Sunday's Crossroads check-in, but one of them caught my eye. It's from Paul Westwood, who has a rather technical question. He says, it might be my settings, but they seem okay on the actual episode on transmission, but why do the colour clips on Crossroads check-in look filmised? Excellent show, by the way, Lee. Well, thanks, Paul. You're very kind. And you are indeed right about the clips looking filmised. You've probably noticed that I look a bit filmised sitting here too. Now, it's all to do with the various technical settings. I'm a bit of a geek when it comes to stuff like this. Hey, I'm a Doctor Who fan as well. What do you expect? Now, on the actual episodes of Crossroads themselves, we're effectively playing them from a digital file copy of the original master tape. But when we insert any clips into a recorded programme like Crossroads Check-In, they've got to go through a certain amount of extra processing just because of the type of computer software that we're using here at Big Centre TV. And the result is that they end up looking filmised, as indeed I do right now. I hope it doesn't spoil things for you though, and don't worry, we're able to keep the actual episodes themselves looking just as they did when they went out all those years ago. Now, Ian Craddock from the Blue Orange Theatre in the Jewellery Quarter was watching the Big Centre channel on TV recently, and he said, I had not realised, and also very pleased, that you do a What's On programme for the city and region. Well, Ian, we certainly do. Now, Chanel presents an edition on Friday nights for the coming weekend, and then there's another edition on Mondays for the following week. And we mention the Blue Orange quite often too. Now, remember, if there's anything you'd like us to mention on What's On, then just get in touch. OK, time to take a look ahead to some of the programmes coming up next week here on Big Centre TV. And Film Fest is our weekend showcase of movies by independent filmmakers. This week we have All Heart, which is being billed as a zero-budget independent feature-length film with an all-female cast which was entirely shot in Brighton and the surrounding area. Now, Hazel is in crisis. The people she might turn to for help have problems of their own and nothing is going according to plan, but there might be another way. Our other film is a retrospective of the work of BAFTA award-winning film and TV director Derek Hayes. Derek is a writer, designer and storyboard artist who has worked on so many projects from the great rock and roll swindle to the classic Jeeves and Wooster title sequence, for which he won a TV BAFTA for Best Graphics. Now, on Monday night at 10, we have Life Stories, and here's Mike Prince to tell us about this week's guest.
In the next edition of Life Stories, we'll be meeting a fearless 95-year-old grandfather from Birmingham who still goes wing walking. He enjoys the thrill of climbing onto an aeroplane, climbing up into the skies, wearing those goggles, coping with the cold conditions, the G-force, and going to places like the Rock of Gibraltar across the Irish Sea, around the Channel Islands. Meet Tom Lackey, 95 and still flying, on the next edition of Life Stories.
what a story, eh? And if you'd like to check out some of our other programmes, just pop over to our website, bigcentre.tv. OK, so that's your postbag for this week. But don't forget, if there's anything else you'd like to talk to us about, maybe tell us what you think about your favourite programme. Tell us if there's something we should be covering, or if you'd like to give someone a special message on the telly. On social media, Facebook and Twitter, just look us up. You can do a search for Big Centre TV. Or if you want to use the good old email, then it's postbag@bigcentre.tv. And if you fancy sending us an actual letter in the post, yes, it's still possible, then our address that you write on your envelope is Postbag, Big Centre TV, 14A Lower Hall Lane, Walsall, WS1 1RL. Now, I'll see you again on Crossroads Check-In on Sunday and also on What's On. And Postbag will be back at the same time again next week. I'll see you soon.